Greetings, flesh creatures. It is I, Megatron. On behalf of TFYLP, I want to congratulate you for listening to the most refined collector podcast on this miserable little planet Earth. Yes. Here you'll find knowledgeable fans discussing every aspect of Transformers and beyond. Now, enjoy the show while I continue my path to complete conquest of all of you miserable biological entities. Predacons, terrorize!
Welcome to another episode of Cut the Tape. This is a show I have to make so that I can keep opening stuff and just getting it on the shelves. Otherwise, I've got all this. This is a mess. Well, today we're playing catch up on some deluxes. I've got all these guys here just waiting to be opened. And I thought, you know what? Let's start with a few fan favorites. We've got, not deep cover. We've got Air Razor. Yeah, an Air Razor. Nobody was asking for Air Razor, but we love it. We've got, nobody was asking for the repaint guy. Junkie on a sparkless bot. You know what this actually reminds me of? Like flashbacks and Beast Machines, where you would see like generic Transformers. Like that's what I think. That's what I think of him. Decius Army Drone. He doesn't look like, that's an Ironhide. That's not a black Ironhide. It's a black Ironhide to me. He's got that little insignia right there, but you know, we can cover that up. I mean, I'm not going to, but you could if you wanted to. And so you'd have a black Ironhide. I mean, this is black Cybertronian mode Ironhide. That's what that is. Ah. Now, these are some guys that I've been meaning to get to for a while now. Run Amok. We definitely want to open Run Amok. Fast Track. We do want to open Fast Track, but Run Amok. Well, he's on the maybe pile. We're definitely opening Trailbreaker and not Sunstreaker today. No. We got some stuff going on in here. I think first, let's get to the most exciting one to me is Air Razor. We got our trusty yellow knife. Now, of course, I bought two. One to. So what I do is I compare them. I look for variances in the paint. I look for variances in the packaging. I look for dings to see which one is better. If there's no differences, I look at how the figure is in the package, the way the figure is facing, and all that helps me determine which one I'm going to open. So this one I'm going to keep sealed. The package is very nice. Both packages are nice. This one is looking more straight on. So she stays sealed. In Japan, Air Razor was a boy. I never looked into what they did with season 2 or 3 of Beast Wars, where they, her and Tagatron have a relationship. I never cared. You know what? Now that I think about it, I think for season 2 it was dubbed as a girl in Japan. It doesn't matter. Two boy Transformers want to hold hands. First of all, I hate sexualizing Transformers because they're robots. But I like the fact that there's boy and female robots, because that's how we understand life. And there's other robots. And you know what? No one's asking for a Botanica but me. I'm asking for a Botanica and a Night Scream. I want a Night Scream. I'd rather have Night Scream than Botanica. All right. Dropping it on the floor is part of the process. If you don't drop it on the floor, then it doesn't work. All right. Packaging. It's a nice bouquet. Vietnam, perhaps? That's an L2 cardboard. This isn't recycled. This is fresh cardboard. Let's see, is it Vietnam? Hey, it's Vietnam! All right. We got a little slip of paper that we always throw away. Warning, choking hazard. And it's listed in all these different languages. English, Spanish, binary, Klingon. You know what? It actually would be cool if they put it in binary here because they're robots. There's no Braille though. No Braille. Tell them to work on that. Now, here's the thing. The packaging is very nice. I mean, I'm not a big fan of packagings that have angles on them because they are harder to pack away. But one thing that we as Americans do, and because America leads in this, it's an American company, Hasbro. We're very wasteful. Look at the size of this figure versus the packaging. It's a lot of cardboard. And I do appreciate how in Japan, for the most part, almost across the board, every toy is packaged nice and tight in the box. Now I understand why they do this, because hey, it's gotta fit in a shelf the right way. You know, you see the wall behind me. I understand why it's done. But are we ever going to advance as a society if we still think like that? And I'm not saying Hasbro has to do this for society to advance. I'm just generally speaking. Americans are wasteful. Make sure you turn the package around. There's weapons tucked away in here. These are real easy for grandma and grandpa to not look for. And they get lost. The packaging is reminiscent of the golden disc, as it should be. It's a key important factor in the Beast Wars mythos. I like that we're getting a deluxe version of Air Razor and not a little scaled down version. We also have a card. And this card is Optimus Prime. Little holographic card. You can peel it. It's more than meets the eye. It's Optimus Prime. He's not in disguise. You know, when Beast Wars came out, I was in high school when season 2 of Beast Wars happened. I was a senior in high school. And I remember thinking, can it get any better than this? I mean, this is a great show. Beast Wars, man. It's a great show. Season 2 had just ended. Optimus Prime had just shown up. Dinobot was dead. I was emotionally invested. And now here we are. That was 1998. We're here 22 years later. And now we have a show coming out soon that's G1 and Beast Wars together. if you told me that when I was a senior in high school, I just, wow. I don't think the quality will be as good as Beast Wars, because Beast Wars and Beast Machines was the shit. Beast Machines gets a lot of hate, but you know what? I appreciate it a lot more, especially after the Unicron trilogy. No, especially after Cyberverse. Yes. So, I love the paint. I love the size of this toy. I love that it's a deluxe character. She's getting the recognition that she needs. There is a repaint coming out as an Amazon exclusive, a remold, as a White Eagle Silverbolt. I think it's called something else. Oh, I think it's called Maximal Skywarp. But originally in Beast Wars, that character was Silverbolt. And then later on came the Fusor Silverbolt, two different characters named Silverbolt. All right. Let's give her a quick spin. I don't often, you know, I don't like to transform things for the first time on the show, but I'm excited to get it. You know, there's a lot of little details in here. Like at the back of this panel, it's not going to show up on here, but the back of this panel has got nice little details on it. Let's see here. I am very familiar with bird anatomy, as I keep chickens. I'm also quite adept at bird law. Bird law is a real thing. Don't let anyone tell you it's not. Bird law. Wow, a little more complicated than I expected. The colors on the toy are different from the packaging. I do like the colors on the toy more. I mean, it's not, this isn't exactly how it transforms. Close enough. I'll mess with her more later. That's cool. Little beak opens and shuts. By the way, I've got 11 chickens. One's named Shiloh. Another's named Petunia. A lot of them don't have names. One is named Hawk. Maybe I should name one Barn Raiser. That is a good sized toy. That is a good sized toy. This is showing Beast Wars the love that it deserves. I would love to have every character from Beast Wars redone. Every character. Even characters that weren't on the show. Like, give me a new, you know what? I'm going to talk about that Rhinox. So we had a Generations Rhinox a few years ago, and now we're getting a Kingdom Rhinox. Man, this wing popped off. That's killing me. Why? Why? Why not take the opportunity to take that Rhinox character? I know Rhinox was a big character, but give us someone we haven't had before, right? Give us a Tigerhawk, or give us an Ant Inferno, right? You got an easy repaint. If you're thinking about repaints, you got Antagony right down the line, right? If you really wanted to do Rhinox, you could have done Transmetal Rhinox. I would kill for a Transmetal Cheetor and Rattrap. You know what? That's a hold your breath and wait and see, because maybe not in like the next year or two, but maybe 4 years from now, I'm calling it. Maybe 4 years from now, we will get transmetal version, especially Cheetor. We'll get a transmetal figure. And I know we got Optimus, Optimal Optimus, but I think more are going to come. I have no inside information regarding this. I'm just looking at the trend and the incredibly great decisions that they've been making as far as character selection. I know I just railed on Rhinox. That aside, if we get a T-Rex, hey, we got a Maximal Skywarp, a Silverbolt coming. Hey, transmetals. It's gonna happen. I'm calling it. All right. This guy's been sitting around so long, he's collected dust. Jeez. I gotta tell you, I love the head sculpt on this. This is a Hoist remold redeco into Trailbreaker. This is more for Cybertron. Earthrise. What does that mean, Earthrise? Is the Earth rising? They're heading to Earth. Wouldn't it be called Earthfall or Arrival? I don't understand the terminology of Earthrise. You know, it's been so long, I even forgot that there was a map on the back of this. I'm saving all the map pieces. I completely forgot there was a map part to that. Instructions, choking hazard. Here we go. I wish you were a little bit bigger, but I'm happy with it. It might be time for me to get a new blade. Really love the arms on this. So, all right. I'm going to tell you a story about Trailbreaker. I had Trailbreaker as a kid, but not for long, because my cousin came over and he broke Trailbreaker's leg off. And I was really bummed about that. His leg was completely broken off. So I remember taking Trailbreaker. I remember taking him and putting him in the trash in front of my cousin and said, he's dead. So he's dead, so he's in there now. And I threw out my Trailbreaker. He was broken, his leg was broken. I wish I'd kept him. I could have maybe glued him, but, you know, I was 5 years old, maybe? I love the arms on this. The fact that you get that, I mean, that is just... This is such a good meld of TV and toy. This one hits home. This so much better than the generation one we got 10 years ago. This is inciting an emotional response. Look at that face. It's perfect for the show, but and then you turn around and you look at the arms. Man, I'm taking this. I don't often have an emotional reaction like this to a toy. I think I'm largely desensitized, but I also think that the very nature of this toy, by the way it looks and the way it transforms, because it's very reminiscent of the G1 Transformer, is inciting a response in me that I have not had in... I can't ever think of reacting like this before to a figure. This is like my childhood all rushing back to me. Crazy. Crazy that I'm capable of a emotional response like this over a toy. I kind of want to get one of these for my daughters to have. I'm stuck now with how the legs go. And the emotional response is gone because I'm stuck with how the legs go. There we go. So you have to take the arms out first for this to pass through. Okay. I think actually what my daughters deserve, or what I would rather get them, is a vintage Trailbreaker or an Encore one. I can't get it to transform. Does it pass the roll test? It's so much smaller in vehicle mode. There were a few Transformers I had as a kid that I clearly remember. And I remember them breaking. I had Ratchet, and the door off the back of it broke. The door that splits open to the med bay, that broke off. And then he disappeared. I remember Trailbreaker. My cousin broke the leg, and I remember putting him in the trash because he was dead. And then he was gone. I remember having all 6 Constructicons and then Hook breaking. And then he was gone. I remember Optimus Prime and an arm breaking off. I remember Jetfire. I don't remember how Jetfire broke, but I had Jetfire, and I remember I must have really liked Jetfire as a kid, because I had a birthday cake with the Jetfire packaging art painted on it. And I remember sitting in front of my fireplace with my Optimus Prime, rolling the truck on the bricks back and forth while the fire was going, and my mom saying, "Don't get it too close, because it's gonna melt." It wasn't gonna melt. I wonder what toys my daughters will carry forward, if any. Kids don't play with toys the way people my age did because of electronics. The world has changed. Hang on to your toys. Toys come in very, very different shapes and sizes. Maybe your car is your toy. Maybe your jet ski. And we're going to call it a day there. Hey, be kind to each other. If you got kids, go play with them. With toys. And if you don't have kids, practice making them. Because that's just as fun. Wash your hands, get vaccinated, and try and find some time to cut the tape.